Alright, in this video I want to explore the polar form of the multiplicative inverse of a complex number. So, in a previous video we've established that the multiplicative inverse of a complex number is such that when we multiply a complex number z by its multiplicative inverse, we get the number 1. And the number 1, of course, is a real number. So if we express z in its Cartesian form, x plus iy, then its inverse is given by x over x squared plus y squared minus I by y squared over x squared plus y squared. Now if we express z in polar form, we say z is equal to r, which is the modulus of z, times cis of the angle theta, or of the argument theta. And we can express this more formally as r outside of cos theta plus I sine theta. And if I take r into the brackets, I get r cos theta plus I by r sine theta. And of course we note that r cos theta is equal to x and r sine theta is equal to y. And this z should have a power of negative 1. So let's substitute these expressions for x and y into the inverse of z. So the multiplicative inverse of z, then, once we have substituted the expressions for x and y in, we should get r cos theta over r squared cos squared theta plus r squared sine squared theta minus I r sine theta over r squared cos theta plus r squared sine theta. Sine squared theta. And if we extract some common factors, so the common factor for the top row is r, so we'll get cosine theta minus I sine theta on the top. And a common factor on the bottom is r squared outside of cos squared theta plus sine squared theta. And then we note that cos squared theta and plus sine squared theta is equal to 1. And I can cancel out the r and the squared. Then the multiplicative inverse works out to be 1 on r outside of cos theta minus I sine theta. So the inverse of z is equal to r cis theta is simply 1 over r outside of cos theta minus I sine theta. And this will lead us into division of complex numbers. So I'll see you on the next video.